They took down my last video, so here it is. So two things I want to say. First, I do not have to be in the trenches fighting. I went to Harvard twice, I've worked for the government. All four of my degrees are from Ivy League. If I wanted to, I could have had a happy life just making a lot of money. Holding up the oppressive systems, knowing that they're oppressive. I'm not on social media for clout. I'm a social media activist because this is part of my theory of change. Second, this trend. There's a world experienced by white people and there's a world experienced by non-white people. Being a person of color in a white world is inherently traumatizing. People of color have to navigate through the trauma, daily trauma. From slums to Harvard, all life experiences that I've had, nowhere in this world is safe from the danger and threat of white women's tears. I've seen people of color CEOs and people of color tenured professors living in fear of white women's tears. And I've actually seen them get into trouble all because a white woman decided that she got her feelings hurt and got offended and she decided to cry manipulatively through a whole performance. And the second she knew that the institutions were on her side, she stopped crying. That is a patterned real life story.